fusion creates the energy that powers the stars. The Z-pinch approach was actually one of the first processes that folks looked at when considering if fusion was possible, in some regards kind of inspired by a lightning bolt. Very early on, folks realized that there were instabilities that would cause the plasma to tear itself apart way before it could get hot enough for long enough to reach those fusion-relevant conditions. However, there have been a number of experiments that were done by Los Alamos National Lab and the Naval Research Lab in the 80s and 90s that seemed to show that using a frozen wire as a starting fuel pellet behaved in a curious way, and they called it anomalous stability. They saw their plasma remaining uniformly like a wire or a column. And they couldn't fully explain it, but it seemed to indicate that there might be a path forward here.
In the mid-80s, we did all sorts of experiments we could within the limitations of the machine. The data kept showing us the same results over and over again.
What we're going to do is we're going to basically work to figure out a good recipe for making fibers.
Now, you don't just find these fibers anywhere. You have to freeze deuterium about 10 degrees above absolute zero, and then you push this blob of deuterium you've frozen through a little hole, much like a Play-Doh set.
There's a little cylinder of ice, and a lot of it.
Then you push the button and current goes through it.
Great, trigger. Looks like fiber is in the hole. Is everyone here?
Yep.
Yeah.
Come down.
Okay, arming the DAX. Okay, charging.
Fiber's good.
The advantage of being able to do this experiment now is that we have a lot more advanced diagnostic tools, including better simulation tools to help support the work, and also some specialty cameras that allows us to take images of the plasma at a billion frames per second to allow us to see what's going on at a very zoomed in micro scale.
Fiber's good.
Watch the gate pressure,
We're still doing
minus
good.
Five,
we're
good,
still
good.
Doing great.
Yes.
So you
might have
ice.
Another fiber coming out.
We have seen a bunch of interesting things, some that we expected and some that we didn't expect to see. But on average, with our modern tools, we can see there is an instability growing from an early stage. And because of that, we don't believe this has a path to a power plant. It's probably possible to get partway to fusion-relevant conditions, but not far enough to actually make more energy than we put into the system. So the decision has been made to wind the project down and also to publish and share the results of our experiment in the hopes that that will contribute to the knowledge of the plasma physics field as a whole. The expectation from the whole field as a whole and even our whole team from the start was the likelihood that this would lead to a power plant was very low. But the potential impact, the reward was so high that it was worth taking something that we knew was a very low likelihood of success. I feel a lot of gratitude to have had the opportunity to have run this experiment.